Hello, everybody. I'm back in Open TDD, unexpectedly, around almost a month after my last video about my second version of Division. And good news is that I managed to earn some money, and I'm going to have a roof over my head for the next month. So that's a good news. And the good news is that I finished the second version of Dividend. However, it's very slow. Now, what's the difference between my previous version and this one? So this is my previous version. As you can see, it's quite big, it's spacious. It got a seven segments, for one for each bit of dividend, and it got 7 8-bit full adders and one subtractor. Actually, this is still full adder, but it works as a subtractor. Now, in this version, we have only one subtractor, so full adder that works as a subtractor. And dividing module is just this part over here, nothing else. But because we need to use this subtractor 7 times, and we have over here 14 bits that need to be adjusted, set separately, one after another. It takes long, long, long time. So 7 times 14, and then plus change for this. This is another memory. This is memory register that freezes the value from subtractor. Otherwise, it will unfortunately change all the time. So it has to be over here. So let's have a look first before we start calculating anything. What we have here. So it looks like one 14 bits memory register, but in reality that's two. One, this is memory register for dividend and quotient. At the beginning, it is loaded with dividend, and then one bit after another will be filled with quotient and shift to the left. And this one over here, it's 8 bits because I need one bit for a sign of number. I call it operational memory register because it is used to create a new number for subtraction. Or yeah, so it if the results for subtraction is below zero, so like -1, -2, last bit of that number is one, and when it's one, we will just shift the value to the left because this is invalid subtraction, and the quotient for that subtraction will be zero for zero. So we will change that one with a NOT gate, and we will get a zero. Now, when the result of subtraction is above -1, it means that we've got the result zero or above zero. So the last bit will be zero, and this circuit will force to replace the memory of the value of this memory register with a new subtraction, and that as well will be shifted one position to the left. And yeah, so that's in short. Now we have another memory register over here. It's not necessary to have it, but it's a kind of let's say it prevents the mess with the display, because the display will be changing all the time if I don't have it. This freezes this this display, and when it comes to the right moment, it will be enabled to change. Now we have some kind of a loop. This is a loop that is divided into 7 sections, and this is kind of let's say hardware programming or punch card, depends how you want to call it. And I think that will be it what I would like to say about this. Let's right now we have over here 54. I want to divide by 5, so that would be 10 and 4/5. Oh yeah, so this memory register prevents the changes, so we have an old value. Now to start our calculation, I need to push this button. It is like an equal button on a calculator. So for example, 54 divided by 5, then you're pressing equals and you got your result. So let's start on pause the game and we start our calculations. So at the beginning, I'm loading this memory register with the value of dividend, and this one will be 7 bits of this will be set with 0, and the last one bit is actually common, the most significant bit of dividend and the less significant bit of operational register, memory register, are it's the same bit. When we're starting loading a new data for subtractor, the subtraction is done, and now we setting one bit after another. Now we're shifting just this one. Again, we're loading new data for subtraction, and now we depends on that result. We or loading a new value into this memory, or just shifting that value one bit to the left. And this one is always shifted to the left and loads the last bit with that value of the quotient. All right, so where we are, we still have two bits to go because we are at the third. We still didn't finish it, so we processing the third bit. It's very slow. And now we're starting doing the one before last. And the last one. Loading the new value and then shifting. Now when the train reach this point, it will enable that display to be changed, and we should have it. So 54 divided by 5 is 10 and 4/5, correct. Okay, let's pause the game. Let's have one more example, maybe something bigger, whatever, 99, I've done it before, I think. 99 by, okay, by 5, it's okay. 99 by 5. Let's unpause the game so we have a new settings over here. So 99 divided by 5. Let's start it. So just pay attention, it will be all those will be 0 green. And this will be loaded with the new value of dividend, and this one will soon after will start all of them at once will make a loop and will pass the value for this subtractor. So let's start, and we're loading, and now we're passing the first signal, and then bit by bit we're processing the first memory register, so it is or shifted or replaced with the value of subtraction, and the other is just shifted one position to the left and loads that value of quotient to that bit. Okay, let's speed it because it will be quite a long time ago, so I'm going to speed up video. So we're going to have now the last loading for subtraction, then last shifting or replacing, now last shifting for dividend quotient memory register, and the next will be the setting of our, so what we've got, 99 divided by 5 equals 19 and 4/5, correct. Now it's an interesting thing, I try to do it with a NOT gate instead of over here. I do it right now with a Lagnat's edge detector. I try to do it with a NOT gate, but the NOT gate lasts too long, and it was actually sometimes desynchronized the system and giving me wrong results. And then I decided to change it for Lagnat's edge detector, and now it's working perfectly. So this is actually a crucial element of this design. The memory and this edge detector, they are crucial elements of this design. I think because it's a very interesting element, I will leave a link to that video where Lagnat explains how this is working in description of my video, because it's really worth to watch it and use it in any projects. It's really great solution for those problems. It just gives you a brief moment green signal. Otherwise this signal over here is all the time red, and when it gets, when this one gets red for a short moment, it will stop the trains, it will release this green over here. There will be just a brief moment that this signal become a green, and that's job done. Everything synchronized in a perfect way. Alright guys, I wanted to explain how this is working on the diagrams, but because there's not much interest in this, so I think I will give up. It takes a lot of time. If someone really is interested how this is working and is interesting in all the logic behind this, just ask question and maybe I will make another video. But right now I think my adventure with arithmetics is done. I've done adding and subtracting with one, multiplying, and now dividing two versions. So I think I'm done with the arithmetics. I'm not sure if I will be making any more videos in OpenTTT. Maybe yes, maybe no. It depends how my life is going to be, because recently it's not very, very, very funny for me. But let's see how it goes. All right. Thank you for your support. Thank you for all the likes, subscribes, for being with me. And I hope see you in the next video. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Oh,